Welcome back. In the 30 or so years since its emergence as a genre, dancehall has never been short of detractors.
Girl, me serious, me have to get you tonight.
But whereas its supporters are strident and open about their devotion and defense of the music, one is hard-pressed to find detractors who are openly taking on the ills of dancehall and its exponents.
My daddy was a bedroom bully.
Veteran journalist Ian Boyne is the biggest, most prominent voice against dancehall. A voice, some will say, in the wilderness. And now the whole world is able to access some, if not all, of Ian's crushing critique of dancehall in this, his latest, where is it? Publication, titled Ideas Matter. A special privilege it is for me right now to welcome on our stage for the very first time, Ian Boyne. Ian, sir.
Hey, it's good to be on stage with you, Winford. Great to be on. It's an honor, man.
Totally, man.
Yeah, it's an honor to be here.
Totally, man. Welcome, sir. Welcome. All right, explain the book for us, Ian.
Yeah, Ideas Matter. It's a compilation of my InFocus Gleaner columns.
Yes.
And the InFocus began in 2001. Actually, the editor, Garfield Granderson, started the special section because I had complained that I didn't have enough space in my columns. And he said, well, we'll create a whole section for you where I could do my long-form journalism and really revel in ideas and explore ideas. And so after a number of years, because a lot of the things that I do are both timely and timeless,
yes,
I said it would be good to compile the work. Oh, and yes, people had been saying, boy, you're writing these serious stuff. We would love to have them in one volume. And so Dr. Henry Lowe, who heads Pelican Publishers, he was game. And the Pelican had published a book earlier for me this year on Profile.
Yes.
You know, about my 25 years on Profile. And so Pelican decided that they would partner with me and the Gleaner to publish this work, which if I could show it here. Mm-hmm. Ideas Matter, Journey into the Mind of a Veteran Journalist. And there are sections to do with international politics,
yes,
local politics, religion, philosophy, the wide
Everything.
Range of things that I've dealt with. But a special section on dancehall,
yes,
which contains some of my most trenchant and hard-hitting
merciless,
yeah,
merciless
on the dancehall.
Yes.
Because, you know, my entry into Wikipedia, yes, is on dancehall. I mean, people in various countries actually write to me when they are doing research projects on the dancehall to get my views.
And you must be surprised by that.
I'm surprised by that, but not too much, because dancehall is a global phenomenon.
Well, I mean, in the scheme of your work.
Because of my work, yes.
Yes, I mean, this is what entered you into Wikipedia. I mean,
it has to be a
surprise that this is dancehall, which is something you pay some attention to, but not most of your time.
On the map. But because there hasn't emerged a great number of persons who have been critical of the dancehall.
Yes.
From the academy, there are people who have been defending dancehall, you know, Caroline Cooper, Donna Hope, Kingsley Stewart when he was there. And a lot of people, the public intellectuals, haven't paid much attention to the dancehall, don't know much about it.
But the big question is, what makes you, what's compelling
you? I love music.
To go after it.
I love music. I love music, and I've been following music for a long time. I'm a vintage music lover. But as a thinker, I have to look at culture. Mm. I have to look at the things that influence the mass of the people. Because I have a great deal of interest in philosophy and in sociology. And when I look at the values of the people, I have to look at those areas that most impact people.
Mm.
And it's not the church, it's not the school, it's not the home. The traditional socializing instruments don't have the kind of power that the dancehall has. The politicians don't have the kind of power that the dancehall have. Mm-hmm. We in media don't have the kind of power that the dancehall has. So the dancehall is an important space that teaches our children and that socializes our people. So I can't ignore what is going on in the dancehall as a public intellectual.
But isn't that a warp in our society, Ian, in our social order, that dancehall is more powerful, more influential than our leaders, our political leaders,
but generally,
our church?
That's true, but that's not unique to Jamaica. Popular culture,
yes,
is what affects the populace most in the U.S. Pop culture is far more influential than politics. In fact, the politicians have to draw on pop culture when they are trying to really make an impact. And let me say that the problems of dancehall don't originate in the dancehall. Dancehall reflects a decadent society. Mm. Dancehall reflects.
So you're conceding those points.
Dancehall is a symptom.
Yes.
Some of those who criticize me don't recognize that I acknowledge. But
yes,
the problem is not with the dancehall. In other words, if you were to get rid of the dancehall, you wouldn't get rid of the problems.
But by extension, aren't the exponents of the music?
Yes.
Aren't they victims, in a sense, of their circumstances?
Absolutely right. But what I'm saying, Winford, is that I believe that the dancehall artists, in fact, I show greater respect for them than those who are supposedly defending them. Because I am saying that they have the power, they have what the scholars call agency, to break away from the influences on them, from the constraints of their conditions. They can decide. There are positive dancehall artists,
yeah,
who are pushing positive lyrics. You have Chronics and others. I think you have Egyptian who's coming
of them,
on. Who's
right? Almost
who's
all of them.
So there are a number of persons
even
who have
those
come from
who,
those same situations.
Yes.
And as you say, even those like Bounty Killer,
yes,
who are known for the gun lyrics,
they are loaded with good lyrics
have
too.
Some conscious songs.
Yes.
Bushu Banta, I mean, I quote something from Bushu in one of the articles where if I can find it, Bushu is sanctioning rape. You know, hear women tell the girl say, if we don't look good. Hear women tell her say, girl, me serious, me have to get you tonight, even at gunpoint.
Mm-hmm.
No, I'm saying that we have to condemn this kind of thing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm saying we can't be neutral about lyrics. I'm going to quote something else from the book. I went into my Stone Love cassette. It was a cassette, please. So I quoted one of my early articles. Stone Love. So I'm going to my Stone Love cassette now. Them this man and feel like we're going to take it and lie down in our bed. Them must be licked them head. Them man, they for dead. No, this kind of lyrics. Them run, but them never reach far. Them never know, so I have my gun in my car. See it then now. Them I go splash pan the tar. You can't promote that kind of thing. This is not revolutionary violence. No.
Yes.
So if a man come now and say, so what would I say about apartheid in South Africa and the ANC's struggle and the ANC's use of violence against apartheid? This is not the kind of revolutionary violence that Bob was talking about. And Bob was talking about Obama Church. There was an ideological reason for that. This is a thing where a man will say, boy, if you diss him or you diss him, woman, you know, him will take out him AK or him SLR. This is a glorification of violence.
Yeah, and you're repulsed by it. But would you not? I think you may be surprised,
yes,
to learn from said artist, Boju Banton, Bounty Killer, and all these artists,
things, yes,
that they agree with you that this is bad lyrics, that it is negative.
Yes.
But then, have you had dialogue with these guys?
Have you
spoken to them one-on-one,
yeah,
man-to-man?
Apart from Vice Cartel. Mm-hmm. Beanie Man.
Yeah.
Certainly I've had dialogue with Beanie Man and some others. You would have a greater
connection with these these artists, and therefore that's why it's good to have this discussion with you, because you can reflect their views.
Yeah.
While not holding their views, you certainly know what they would say. You know,
I know where they're coming from.
That's right.
And this is what I'm saying about they knowing that the lyrics is bad, and in fact they're bound to kill on many occasions. Condemn.
Yeah.
His own lyrics right here on stage, on this platform.
But they're playing to an audience.
Absolutely.
The people want it.
There's a market for that. And you go after them and you want to pull them away from this. You want to stop them. You're saying, guys, do not become what you perceive to be.
Absolutely.
Do not become what even the so-called bigger heads
always
prescribe for you.
Why they're good for.
Do not fulfill that.
Play into the stereotype.
Okay, so you're going after him. But here's
you're not going after the genre, you know.
No, I understand.
Like, so you have the same beat, you have the same sound.
But what do you give? What does he give? What does he get for what you're asking him to give up?
Yeah.
What does he get in return? Because here is the piece of lyrics that is selling, connecting, resonating in the space. Where do we put the fans of the music in all of this? Where do they play in this discourse? Where do you play those who are demanding this thing and buying it and propelling these artists into superstars?
But the fact of the matter is, as one man said famously, people don't know what they want until they see it.
Mm.
The market will go for the positive thing. I mean, look at the impact that Chronics is having.
Yes.
You don't tell me that when Bounty Killer had put out conscious lyrics that people would gravitate toward it.
I'm glad. All right, good.
That they would.
I'm glad you brought up Chronics, because he and others, maybe more Chronics out there right now than dancehall artists.
Yes.
The negative vibes that you saw against.
Yes.
But they're not getting the ears of
the
consumers.
Forward.
They're not getting the forward.
Yes.
What they're putting out is not necessarily resonating. I tell you something, if you listen to the song that break Chronics, Pants Pound Waste, which is a dancehall track, isn't Chronic's best work.
Yes, yes.
But he had to use the dancehall genre, the dancehall style.
Yeah, to buzz.
Like a bully pulpit.
Yes.
Get your attention
and
then pull through, which you may commend him and say others should do it. You may commend him and
the answer to you. Yes,
but
others can do it.
There you have it. So they will tell you that much of what they're doing is a man of eater food.
Yes.
Remember now, economic.
But my father don't need that now.
Not anymore.
That's right.
I would agree that he doesn't. Yes. But when that song that break him, that Maropan Ground song, in 2005, when that song came, at this time of day, Mavado's next, before that song, next biggest issue in life was a meal.
Yes.
He knows violence. He knows how to go to bed without food.
Yes.
No clothes, no education, nothing.
There's
nothing.
A
meal is his
that.
Biggest problem. If him do a lyrics, Ian, that gives him power, that makes you write about him, he's not going to give up that because me and you are offended by it.
Yes.
He is going to hold on to that until he sees an alternative that will keep him relevant and feed him and do all the things that he's now able to do as a result of negative, destructive, poisonous lyrics.
Do we just accept the deterioration of the society just because some people want to eat a food?
No.
Should that be?
We should not. And
do you feel that dancehall would die, Winford?
Yes.
If we were to excise it of the gun lyrics, of the celebration of spreading man marrow on the ground, do you think dancehall would die?
No.
And don't you see that dancehall is being marginalized now, globally? That reggae is perhaps at its lowest ebb. Precisely because it has become so narrow, it has lost the universal appeal.
Agree, and hence now the revival of One Drop. But hold on, wouldn't you say that
dancehall
has cleaned up some in the last 5 years? In your observation?
There have been some improvement.
There have been some cleaning. I credit the Broadcasting Commission. They have done a fantastic job in controlling what comes on air.
But there's still the dancehall space.
But there is where...
Which is not controlled.
But this is what I'm saying. There are regulatory
absolutely
moves
right
that can be made
very good
to deal with it. Without real censorship.
Absolutely.
But my problem with you...
And you have made...
My problem with your attacks, you know, yes, is the going after the individual who is trapped in his circumstances and is doing
anything...
You
the same argument to justify prostitution.
Hold on.
You think it's okay for a woman to prostitute herself?
I don't think...
Man to prostitute himself with other men because he's hungry?
No.
Eh? You wouldn't back that?
No, I wouldn't.
Suppose a man meet a rich man from uptown, and the rich man wants to set him up in an apartment and all that kind of thing,
right,
and him give sexual favors. You wouldn't say
but
that's
I don't
right
think dancehall.
But your view is that because a man want to eat a food and because things hard,
I should
take my critical gear from them.
I don't have the answers, you know.
Yeah.
I am saying that he knows how to get a forward and eat a food and drive a range and live uptown and travel the world.
Yeah.
If him do a lyrics, hold on now. What's the alternative? He is going to, the first thing he's going to tell you, that if I were to respect my social responsibilities and to respect the societal rules, I will be trapped in my circumstances forever. Because I know many people who are law-abiding,
true,
decent
who no reach
people
nowhere,
who no reach nowhere, and nobody speak about them.
Yeah,
nobody
true
respect them.
True.
They're sick and can't even get.
So
get
the issue now is how far a man is willing to damage the society for his own advancement.
I don't think the society.
So we as a society,
I don't think the society can be damaged.
We have to think about the group, you know. We can't think about one or two individuals bussing
cool
and making money. So
agree. But society, I don't think society can be damaged by a dancehall or
don't think so
or a few guys.
You really do.
If
you
the society
think music has no influence?
No, I'm not saying it doesn't. But I'm saying
advertising.
I am saying if we yes give, I think education, for example, because I can tell you a whole list of a whole list of
all this, people now go read a book.
A whole list of alternatives, are ways we can approach the problem.
Yes.
Based on my own observation, I think the way we go about it, bashing these guys, hitting hard at them, we understand and we know, and they know that what they're doing is wrong.
Yes.
But I tell you this, they are not going to give it up unless they can see what they're going to get back in return. Life is about that.
But the Broadcasting Commission has forced some changes. You admitted that.
Yes.
So it means that we can use the power of the state.
But
media.
How far can you push that?
It has
how
had
can
some influence.
Push. It does.
If
but
we in media name and shame them.
Yes.
If we in media name and shame them, and we help to develop a critical mass against certain types of lyrics. I mean, are you indifferent about lyrics that promote carnal abuse? You wouldn't be.
No.
You wouldn't say, boy, if a man talk about, you know, having sex with a 10-year-old, you would not be tolerant of that.
I am saying
the same way we would not be tolerant of that. We wouldn't be tolerant of misogynistic lyrics.
Yes.
Are lyrics calling for people to kill homosexuals?
We are not.
We shouldn't be tolerant of
these. And
that's
why
things
we should go after, we should go to the source. We should fix the social system in
but
Jamaica.
But the social system won't take a time to fix.
Yes, I agree, but it seems to me that we
my
are
view
afraid.
Is, let us do both at the
it
same
seems,
time.
Right.
But if you read me,
cool,
if you read this book, you will see that I take a consistently left of center critique of the society.
Yes, but you say in
the society needs to be overall politically and economically.
I'm consistent. I agree with you.
I'm consistent.
I know you go hard
at
those
society
who are running this country.
Of course.
But at the same time, you're asking them to rein in these DJs.
I don't really ask them to
rein
in. I'm asking the DJs to think about their social.
No, you ask the government should rein in. I'm trying to find
it. No, I don't believe. I'm not asking for censorship. What I'm asking for is for a developing consciousness about the impact that music can have on people. And
absolutely,
I'm saying, why reinforce the negatives? We know that it is not the dancehall artists who introduce guns in Jamaica. It's politicians.
Mm-hmm.
It's politicians who use the people. The two parties have used the people and have promoted violence for their own ends. But I am saying the dancehall artists
have further victimized themselves and the poor by glorifying violence. We're a society, we can't work out our problems. The simplest dispute, a man wants to end that with the gun. That's not helping us. And it is mostly the poor people, it's mostly the ghetto people who are being killed.
Yes.
A lot of us in the middle class, we have means of escaping generally. The violence. My attack against negative dancehall is a plea for the lives of poor people. I am defending poor people's lives.
When one reads your articles and read your books, I have no issues about your intent, you know. We'll probably be trying to go to the same place. But my approach is different because I'm saying to you this, that I would want to bring these guys to, I can cite some solutions.
Yes.
I believe, for example, that these guys should be brought to the table as equals.
Yes, yes, yes.
To we.
That's true.
The suit wearers.
Yes, yes, and they are. Equals.
They're equals.
Yes.
And bring them to the table, win them over from the criminal element.
Yes, yes.
And show them in tangible ways what they're going to get for giving up their bad ways, for destroying the youths who are listening to them.
Yes, yes.
Because they know that what they're doing is not good. They are the first to tell you that it's not.
Yes.
But they don't have, what's the alternative? Take a gun. A man has the option to take a gun and start kill people for food or to make bad lyrics that some call poison.
That reinforce others taking the gun.
Yes.
To kill other people.
He sees the alternative and sees himself.
Yes.
Either I'm go that way or I'm sit down and die of anger.
But we have to show that those are not the only two alternatives.
No.
It's not just someone that taking the gun or singing about the gun. That there are other things he can do, and he can use the same dancehall genre for positive effect.
Of course, many are doing that.
Others are
doing it. The space is loaded with that. But what I'm saying is that
if you lose the gun lyrics, if you lose the objectification of women, dancehall would still survive. In fact, it would do better.
Dancehall generally
will
survive.
It would have a bigger audience.
But the individual,
than the little,
the few man them we have issues with.
Yes.
May not survive. That is the issue, you know.
We have to think about society, we can't think about them few man then.
Fine. But what do you do
them
with that man?
Them few man have the money and the poor people must suffer because they are contributing.
Why is it that the society, that this man and his poisonous lyrics resonate?
It resonates.
Why does it resonate?
There's a book called Pedagogy of the Oppressed.
Yes.
The oppressor's ideology is internalized by, it's an ironic thing.
Yes.
That the oppressor's ideology and the oppressor's hate is accepted by the oppressor. No?
Mm-hmm.
So the oppressed express the very subjugation, you know.
Well,
and the dancehall man them is a part of that. The dancehall man them reflect that. The dancehall man them should be revolutionary.
Yes, but okay.
So them are reinforced the very thing. And the uptown people, when the violence and all that go on, the uptown people see that, you know, they are not capable of anything better.
I don't think
what do you
expect?
They don't go to university and so on. Yeah. I am saying, even though they don't go to university, they have the creative capacity to produce world-class music without that.
I don't think we're short of positive dancehallers and one top reggae artists in our space.
We want to make all of them positive.
Positive, right.
Is that an impossible dream?
But hold on. The reason why we are talking about the few man
more cartels and Mavados.
The reason why we're talking about these few people is because they use the same poison to get relevance, to get listened to emerge from nobody to somebody we talk about.
Yes.
And so long as we cannot find him an alternative for him to continue to live the dream, he is going to hold on to that.
So,
and if you get rid of who exists now, Ian,
new
ones will emerge because they, as we ask,
the society,
why does it resonate?
It's true. The society,
because it is ripe for it. The people, the consumers of these things are there.
We need to fix the society.
Know, in the 1970s,
we need to fix the society.
In the tribal 1970s, young people were taught hate. I think you write about
of course,
that too.
Of course,
they were taught hate.
Of course,
in their community.
Yes,
hate that guy over there because he wears green.
Party.
Hate him because he's wearing
absolutely
orange.
Absolutely right.
And
the dancehall come and reinforce that.
Well, if you look at the age of these dancehall artists,
yes,
They were born in the 1970s.
Yes.
Bounty and Beanie
yeah.
are the two biggest
products yes.
of the most prominent,
yes.
the longest lasting yes. rivalry in dancehall, yes. and that created a whole barrage of some of these negative lyrics.
In the 60s, we had poverty.
These kids, they were children when the tribal 70s exist.
Yeah, my, the politicians.
That's when the poison was created by politics.
The politicians.
But these guys are just dispensers of the poison.
And I'm saying they don't have dispensers.
Okay.
So they are being used.
But in dispensing the poison, he's eating food and traveling the world and driving range and living in big house here and not going to give it up. I am saying, sir, that if we bring him now, that he's eating food and exposed to the world. And do you know, too, that when these guys go on tour, they change? Are you noticing that side of it? They go overseas,
so they
get exposed.
And market.
I don't want to call names. So they are changing. They are changing when they understand the wider world, global space.
Yes.
They come back with a different attitude.
Of course.
They are more respectful of law and order.
Yes.
They are buying more into their social responsibility because we are not teaching them.
Yes.
When some of us were had food and homes and so on, these guys were on the street, like being a man on the street, trying to eat a food.
That's
true.
Just a food. In the 60s, where all of them come from? Trenchtown.
Yes.
Right? Dilroy and Dilroy.
Akama, hold on now. Akama, Akama.
Leroy.
That was when Jamaica.
The 60s were violent. The 60s were bad.
At that time,
unemployment was high in the 60s.
The hope. We had hope in the country that time, in our politicians.
But that's
the time.
That's when Sierra gave his halves and
we had hope.
Things were bad in the 60s.
As a new independent nation, we held on to the promises by our leaders.
But by the late 60s, that hope had been eclipsed.
Ah. And by
that's
the
why 70s, Manley came in 72.
Yes, but hold on now. In the 70s.
Yeah, we heard everything crashed. Yeah, Ethiopia came from everything crashed.
Such was the situation. Listen to the music of the 70s now when it became militant.
Yes.
Okay,
and
Bernard Spear and Bob and these guys now
precisely.
Start stepping on the status quo.
Fight against the system.
Yes.
That was a different kind of militant.
Because the people had lost their hope in leadership.
Yes.
And by late 70s, they went underground to create a new genre called dancehall.
Yes.
Because the big names, the Bob Marley and them now, were now being consumed in Europe. And they were more making music.
Yes.
To meet the taste of the European and the external market.
Yes.
The kids, the youngsters, the new generation of Jamaicans wanted something fresh. And they went back to the sound system and created dancehall.
Yes. A great
on the sound system.
Yeah, and a great genre.
And by the turn of the 80s, it burst into mainstream with such fervor that nobody knew where it came from. And to this day, we are debating about it. That is not music.
Genre.
What is it doing here?
I believe in it.
It's nasty, whatever. But the truth be told, the poison by the political establishment is being dispensed by these artists.
Yes.
You leave a people to them on their own, they find their own way in life.
Yeah.
And that's exactly what's happening. Until we address that, and you say it's a long-term fix.
Yeah, but we must deal with that.
We need to deal with it.
Because
we could talk till we die.
Absolutely right.
In my view, I have the same passion that you have about fixing the music, hearing good lyrics and so on. But it is, we must tackle this.
Absolutely.
And stop talking
so
about we can't do it.
We agree with that.
We can do it.
Fix the society.
Yes, but the condemnation of the artist and these things.
It's a condemnation of negative dancehall.
Right? I still hold
and it's an encouragement to the artist to do better. I'm saying they can do better. But for those who want to get the book, all the JCDC stores have it. Pelican is published by Pelican Publishers. People can check Pelican. And those who are doing research on dancehall, 12 solid pieces of column writing.
Excellent, Ian Boyd, as usual. Any of your work, TV work,
can't talk too much about my TV work, I said. What is that anyway?
Of course.
Freedom we deal with, of course. It's one media, you know. National Journalism Week, you know.
Profile.
So it's great. You can't call a name
religious
of the police station.
Hard talk.
Good.
Of course. Why
one
not?
Media. Great.
Yes, man.
Good for us to be on.
We have to come back.
Great to be on your stage, Winford.
Anytime.
Yes.
Because you have to come back.
Yeah, man.
We have to talk more about this.
And you probably talk more than me as a host for my program.
First time ever.
You out talk your guests. That's a Boyne feature, you know.
The first time ever. I'm drawn into a debate about about anything.
Great to have been with you.
Because it's you, Ian, and I couldn't resist the temptation to fire back some shots.
Shots, why you see, your metaphor. But you're a dancer, man, anyway.
About this.
But problem.
It's great to have you right here on stage. And anytime, man, anytime, come back and talk to us more about the music. Because we can't find people like you with the intellectual capacity. We can't find enough people who are calling it the way you feel it should be called.
You're very kind.
You're calling it as you see it. And as much though I do not always agree with you, most of the points I agree with, yes, about the poisoning of the youth, yes, and all these things, I agree with. But the approach is what I don't agree with, and that you should stop that you can stop the man by bashing him,
yes,
from eating food,
yes,
if him think I eat food. That's my issue, and I think I can cite a whole list of things that we need to do in this society to have to fix that. So, Ian, thanks again, sir,
great
for coming through
all
and talking to us.
You're
right here on stage. Well, there you have it. Our very, very special guest, Ian Boyne, right here on stage.